you're not. Here comes mama.
Hello world, hello RuPaul's Drag Race. I am Monica Beverly Hills, 27, from Owensboro, Kentucky. This is my audition tape for RuPaul's Drag Race Season 5. I hope you're ready, because the ship is ready to sail. Woo-hoo! Hello, my name is Juan Emmanuel De Jesus Anaya. I'm 27 years old. I was born and raised in Chicago, Illinois. That is my hometown. Currently, I am living in Owensboro, Kentucky. Yes, I said Owensboro, Kentucky. My current occupation is drag, and it's been drag for the last 7 years. And my couple of personality traits that I have as myself, Juan, I'm a little bit more reserved, unlike what I am when I'm in drag. When I'm in drag, I'm very, very, very outgoing, I'm very loud, I'm very in your face, I'm daring. I've since I was little, I've always taken a lot of risk. Some of them good, some of them bad. I'm the party, basically. When I'm there, I mean, I'm there to party, I'm there to have a good time. I live like it's my last every day. I've been like that since I was younger. I don't understand that about me, but it's gotten me good places so far. Out of drag, I'm pretty much the same, but there's certain things I won't do that I would do when I'm in drag. I guess I think I'm more comfortable sometimes when I'm in drag. It allows me to have a voice that I don't have when I'm Juan, or I didn't have, you know, before I found Monica. A little bit of my life story and a little summary. When I was living with my mother, and I started doing these little things like, yeah, I was gay and I came out. I've been out since I was 11 years old, but I started to have this obsession with wanting to perform, but not wanting to perform as Juan, because I've been performing since I was little, you know, in dance groups and stuff. I started to have this urge, this little itch to start dressing up in women's clothing and going out on weekends, you know, and portraying myself as this Monica character. At first, my friends took me to a gay bar, and they actually had drag shows. And to me, drag queens were a little bit weird and a little bit like, you're not really all up there, and why are you wearing women's clothing, and does that really make you feel? I don't know. It's just a whole bunch of stuff, judgmental stuff I had in my head about it. And this one guy came up to me, and he's like, he was a show director. And he showed a lot of interest in me, and he said, like, okay, do you want to start performing? And I'm like, in drag? I'm like, sure, why not? 7 years later, here I am. I mean, I think those were, like, my life after that, when I first started to come into drag, was amazing. I mean, it was like a drug, that high, the screams, the people, oh my god, you're beautiful. Oh my god, so talented. But I love being on stage, like I said. For some reason, I always known that I was meant to be something bigger than what I was. I listened to a lot of the wrong people, I'll tell you that much. Because there came a point where I had such a great amount of success where I found myself dealing with a lot of personal issues that I'd never dealt with from when I was little and stuff that happened in my childhood, and so much emotion and pain that I was holding on to myself, holding into myself, not really letting nobody know. I found myself in a crazy mess. I ended up being addicted to cocaine. Not addicted as in where I was out in the streets and I was poor. It's just I was basically doing shows to get high, to have my fix. And for a lot of years, I could not admit that to myself. I think this day, even saying in front of this camera, is kind of hard to say that. I just found myself, you know, going to shows and passing out and being high, and, you know, I was ruining myself. I didn't even know, but I had so much pain inside. So I just decided, I had talked to my mom, and I just left. I left Chicago. I left it all. I wanted just to get away, and I needed time to myself. So I moved here to Owensboro, Kentucky. What does drag mean to me? Drag means everything to me. So many beautiful relationships, as in friends, family. It allows me to be me at the end of the day, and I love that about drag. You know, it gives you a voice. That's what drag gives me. It's really fascinating to get ready, because I've always been feminine looking. actually accused of always having plastic surgery and stuff. I'm like, honey, please, I can't sometimes even afford to pay the rent, let alone plastic surgery. Thank you, mommy, daddy. But, yeah, about a good hour and 30 minutes. Yes, I'm very competitive, and I'll do what I have to do to get to where I want to get in this industry, you know? My strengths. I would be considering to say everything, but I'm not. Number one, it has to be my makeup. I think I'm very... I give the image that I have in my head of Monica, I definitely portray it when I do my makeup. I'm very, very strong when it comes to the makeup. Very, very strong. That's why I think, why would RuPaul's judges want me? First and foremost, I'm entertainment. And what you see is what you get, and I'm me 24/7, honey. I have a very outspoken personality. I basically have no filter. I say what's on my mind. I literally blurt it out sometimes. That gets me in trouble.
Monica has so many different looks. A couple of good pieces I love out of my closet is this red, beautiful, beautiful gown I had made by one of my friends. It's see-through, fun, flirty, and sexy. Everything that Monica is and stuff. My cocktail dress, the Real Housewives, I call it. Rocker chick glamorous, androgynous look here. I wear this with a cute little panties and some boots and my rude boy outfit. Love, love, love. I seen it in the video and I had to have. I couldn't resist. I actually made this by hand. I painted all these swirls and stuff, and it's my Beyonce. I use it for pretty much anything. End of Time, Run the World, all of that. I call this the Black Widow. This is from my Alanis Morissette. You ought to know I love that song. One of my faves and one of my money makers. This is made. Diamonds and pearls are a girl's best friends. The one arm, which is my favorite. One of my favorite and last pieces I'm actually going to show you is this dress that my friend had made for me. It is made out of yarn. Don't get no better than this. It is so, so, so sickening. The Whitney look. When it comes to Whitney, like me, it is all about the performance. It is never about anything else but the performance, and that's why I give you, just like today, Miss Whitney Houston. People always told me my drag mind them of was RuPaul. I could do her. Bring back my girls. I love her. She's an inspiration to all of us. And the only thing I'm missing is that $100,000 check. And I cannot wait to get my hand on that check. Because, honey, it's been 7 years in the making, and I'm ready. Bring back my girls. This is another look I have. Everything that Monica Beverly Hills is. Sexy, seductive, is cunt.
Melody, you're telling me.